Have you ever wondered what would happen to your fish if they'd never sleep? You see, the problem here is you don't actually know if your fish sleep in the first place. Fish aren't humans, and unlike us, they don't die directly from sleep deprivation, as far as we know. So what you really want to ask yourself is, do fish sleep at all? Time to find out. To get your answer, first you have to know these two basics. If fish sleep in general, and how fish sleep exactly. Knowing this will later help you understand how you can tell when your fish sleep and what they need to rest well for the right amount of time. So by the end of this video, you'll know so much about how fish rest that I'll give you a fish sleeping expert diploma. But in order to get there, first you have to break down the most fundamental question. Do fish sleep? This could sound stupid. Everybody sleeps, right? Wrong. Here's why. Most sleep research there is focuses on mammals' sleep. Basically, human and animal sleep is recognized after two basic criteria: a change in the patterns of the electrical activity in the brain, and if that is not available, a prolonged time of eye closure. Unfortunately, none of these apply to fish, which tells us that fish never actually sleep in the traditional way. Because 1. Fish don't have the same complex brain structures as humans, so it's impossible to detect such sleep-related electrical activity. And 2. Because most fish don't have eyelids. Hence, it's also impossible to assume they're sleeping without seeing them keep their eyes closed for longer. It could come across as creepy, but that's that. Fish don't close their eyes when they sleep. Or ever. However, fish do rest too. And this is where it gets interesting, because now we can talk about what you really want to know. How do you know if a fish is resting? The good news is there are 4 other practical criteria to identify sleeping behavior. And just for convenience, I'm going to call it RAIT. They generally apply to all living beings, including fish. On this note, you can recognize that your fish sleep when they remain almost completely still, and they do this at around the same time every day, in about the same posture and location, all of that while they become less sensitive to anything that usually disturbs them. In simple terms, if your fish remain almost completely immobile at about the same hour every day, usually picking the same favorite spot and being unbothered by your noises or movement, then it's probably safe to assume they're in a resting state. However, this is not enough to fully understand how your fish sleep. There's something even more important that you need to look for before you see the full picture, and that is, what distinctive sleeping patterns do your fish have? Because depending on factors like age, time of the year, reproductive status, food availability, presence of predators, and more, they can have totally different sleeping habits. But by far, the way they sleep especially varies by their species. And that's what we're going to look into. The brown catfish, for example, was observed to sleep in a typical posture, keeping its tail flat on the ground. Species like the Spanish hogfish, the bluehead, and the wrasse show a much decreased sensitivity while resting. In the ocean, the wrasse even bury themselves under the sand, on the bottom of the ocean at night. Pretty grainy bed to sleep on, wrasse mate, but whatever floats your boat. Moreover, on the decreased sensitivity thing, the requiem shark can actually be touched, poked, or even lifted up to the surface of the water during nighttime without even flinching. Imagine someone taking you out of the atmosphere while you sleep, and you not even feeling a difference. Moving on, the zebrafish also has an interesting sleeping pattern. They appear to float horizontally or with their heads a bit lifted, while the speed of their gill and mouth movements slows down by almost 50%. But well, zebrafish are also amongst the few species that actually have some well-developed neuronal structures that are sufficient for sleep regulation, which is why how they sleep in terms of behavior and psychology looks a lot like how mammals sleep. There are also fish who just make it so obvious they're sleeping because they don't move at all, like the convict and rainbow cichlids, who often rest in an immobile state, keeping their pelvic fins lowered all the way down. Or Mozambique tilapias that rest at night on the bottom of their tank. There are even some parrotfish that, in order to feel safe, sleep in their own self-made mucus cocoons. How cool is that? Actually, their translucent mucus has a lot more useful functions, so we made another short video where we explain everything if you're curious. So yes, fish rest, but not all do it in the same way. I think what's best to remember from all of this is, know your fish. And with that, we're getting to the last and most crucial part of our video, which is how to actually make sure your fish get a good sleep. and what happens if they don't. But before that, let's do a quick recap. Here's what we know so far. Number one, that fish rest, but not like us humans. They rest with their eyes open because they lack eyelids, and there are some patterns pointing they turn sleeping mode on. But it's not the kind of sleep that we are used to experience. Number two, there are four major factors you can assess to know if your fish is sleeping. And those are if they remain completely still, at around the same time every day, in about the same posture, and while they become less sensitive and receptive. And number three, fish have distinct sleeping patterns, which means there's no one size fits all. While most of us humans sleep with our eyes closed in a lying position, fish sleep in various positions and conditions, depending on species and environmental factors. However, knowing all this is utterly useless to you unless you also know the last missing piece of information that we kept for the end of this video. How do your fish get the best out of their sleep? Why a good sleep? Because bad things can happen to fish if they don't rest enough. Yep, you heard that right. If you've never wondered what would happen to your fish if they'd never slept, I'm going to break it to you. Although so far there is no documented case of fish death occurring purely from lack of sleep alone, fish are still negatively affected if they don't rest enough in a state of inactivity. According to BBC Wildlife magazine, sleep deprivation can cause cichlid fish to be less active the next day. For zebrafish, it's far worse. Research shows lack of sleep disrupts their cognitive performance, which means their memory and learning abilities are affected. They are not as responsive, and their attention span reduces. As a result, they also seem to try and make up for their lost sleep with their very first next occasion. So yes, it's important that your fish rest, because as different as they do it, not resting is still harmful to them. They need to sleep enough, which means they don't wake up too early, and they need to not have their sleep interrupted by things that bother them. Here's how you do this in three simple steps. Step 1. See what type of sleeper your fish is. Before you can make sure your fish sleep well with your help, you need to see how they sleep well naturally, even if you don't know their exact sleeping patterns yet. Check on them regularly. What is their favorite spot to rest? Do they do anything unusual while they rest? At what time of the day do they become more inactive? This is particularly important because naturally your fish can be diurnal, which means they are up all day and rest when it's night and dark, nocturnal, meaning they're active at night and rest in daylight, or crepuscular. That's actually when fish are more active in the morning and in the evening, and more static during the rest of the day and night. You may not know all these from the beginning, but don't worry. Wait, watch, observe. Even if they don't close their eyes, it won't take you long to understand their pattern. And once you do, respect it. Try not to bother them with light, food, or whatever during their resting state, because that will disrupt their sleep and potentially harm them. Give them day and night. This is crucial so they can actually regulate sleep and other functions in sync with their natural rhythm. Simply put, provide them with regular times of darkness and light. Don't keep them only with the lights on, because too much brightness can stress them out and disrupt their natural functions, especially if they don't have hiding spots. Don't keep them only with the light off either, because fish can see well in the dark. Yes, they can see in low light, but not in complete darkness. The best way to keep them happy and healthy is to provide a balanced, natural, homey environment, and that implies a cycle of day and night. And finally, step 3, give them a cozy place to sleep. You wouldn't be able to sleep peacefully and rest well in a room that's too hot, too noisy, or too risky. There aren't many similarities between how people and fish sleep, but this is one of them. If they don't feel safe and comfortable, they might become insomniac and develop a sleep disorder. So you have to check all boxes to make sure they feel home enough to rest. Don't forget the light switcher. You can only give them their day and night cycle if you don't forget to turn the lights on and off. So yeah, don't forget. Adapt their feeding time to their sleeping patterns. Notice when they sleep and then create a feeding schedule that fits. Don't feed them right before they sleep so they don't get stirred. And definitely don't pour food over them while they rest. How would you like someone to pour snacks over you while you're trying to restore your energy? Check the water temperature. Too hot or too cold will have your fish stressed out about potential dangers and discomfort. Research the ideal water temperature for your species and keep it that way. and there you go. Make their space more welcoming. You can add corals, plants, or mini caves to create a comfortable, familiar environment. And there you go. You can wish your fish sweet dreams. Wait. Do fish have dreams? We'll leave that for one of our next videos. And if you have any other questions, just pop them up in the comments and we might answer in one of our next videos. So if you haven't yet, please don't forget to subscribe. It's literally free and only takes 1 second of your time, but it means so much for us to have you close when we post our next investigation on cool underwater facts. Alright friends, till the next time, thank you for watching.